Knowing the language makes navigating through cancer land a lot easier. It also helps us feel more in control of our destinies because we can make better decisions when we understand the lingo. Today, Dr. Erba and Dr. Ellen Atopa Johnson will discuss grade and stage, two words that take on a new meaning after a cancer diagnosis and greatly influence both the course of treatment and prognosis. We'll also look at how our individual biology influences both the cancer and approach to treatment.
What happens in cancer is that there's a breakdown in that organization such that the relationship between cells to one another is lost. And part of that relationship requires an organizational closeness. During the cancer process, it's advantageous to the cancer cell for its own long-term survival to depart from that organization and start to spread to other places.
Staging is the process that the clinician does with the patient. So once a diagnosis is made, we want to know where in the body that tumor is for a number of reasons. One is to tell what type of therapy the patient should receive. So for example, if it's an early stage or low stage and localized to an organ, it can often be cured with surgery or radiation therapy alone or a combination, as opposed to more advanced stage where the disease is already spread and you have to think about more systemic therapies, treatments that go everywhere in the body to take care of the disease. And so a clinician will do a staging evaluation to look at prognosis and also come up with the best therapy. The tests that are done in that staging evaluation depends on the clinician's knowledge of what that tumor normally does. So for example, if we had a scan of toenails, we're not going to do a scan of toenails in a person with lung cancer because we know lung cancer doesn't go to toenails.
So histologic grade, the grading is a description of the microscopic appearance of the cells. It is informative to the clinician in that it depicts the degree of abnormality of the cells. When you assign a high histologic grade to a cell, it implicitly informs the clinician that this is a tumor with a tendency to an aggressive clinical course. Now, ideally, that information is also going to be conveyed in the context of stage, which Dr. Erba described earlier, which is the clinical evaluation of the extent to which the tumor has spread from its primary site of origin. So high grade does not mean high stage, and high stage does not mean high grade. It just conveys some of the biological properties. When you see the grade, you'll say this is likely to be an aggressive tumor, and there's a system by which numbers are assigned to give an indication of how aggressive histologically, that is microscopically, the tumor looks.
So one issue for people to understand, and which is difficult, is cancer is not always the same. It isn't the same in different people. And so it's not one disease. These cancers of different organs behave very differently and have different underlying events, genetic changes that lead to them. But moreover, we are learning that even when we look at something under the microscope and we say, aha, that's breast cancer or that's prostate cancer or lung cancer, that there can be differences between that cancer, the genetics of that cancer in different people. And that's what we're investigating right now. And what we are finding in a variety of malignancies is how heterogeneous these cancers are. That brings up the challenge. It's the hope for the future, because by getting these samples from our patients and evaluating these genetic changes, typically done in pathology labs and molecular diagnostic labs, we are going to learn about the biology of the disease and hopefully in the future be able to have better drugs that can interfere with the cancer process. But that process may be very different in one person and or another person with the same disease under the microscope. So it's quite a challenge, and it really underscores the importance of people with cancer allowing biopsies to be taken for research purposes so we can understand this heterogeneity of the tumor, which will ultimately lead to much better therapies than what we have today.